All right, this seems like a pretty good hand. I've only got one equipment left to get with these two stone forges. Oh no, I've got a collared as well. So, this will work. Depending on what I draw, I have to decide whether I want to play Evolving Wilds turn one or just play Steplings. So, we'll see. All right, Inquisition resolves. It's not too big of a problem. I've got a lot of everything. I mean, he could take Sword if he really wanted to. I don't really care if he's not going to take a Stone Forge, I don't think. And even if he takes Steplings, that just means I get to play Evolving Wilds turn one. So the somewhat awkward hand actually works out when you get Inquisition, because there's nothing in this hand that is not replaceable. All right, so he takes the Steplings, which again makes my decision easier for turn one. No reason to sack it now. Might as well wait to see what he does. Though, I mean, I guess it doesn't matter whether I get Mountain or Plains because I've got Arid Mace in hand. But hey, he could be playing like Spreading Seas or something. Don't want to get too hasty. Squadron Hawk. Alright, I'll get a Plains, I guess. Since I know I need a Plains, and that way, you know, I guess it gives me a little more options on the Arid Mace. Like I said, it doesn't really matter. Alright, well, that's kind of expensive. Let's get a Stoneforge out there. The reason I'm getting Stoneforge here is because it can tap for mana by putting Sword in, and playing a Squadron Hawk doesn't really help against his Hawk. So I think I'm actually just going to want the Basilisk color here. I've got plenty of guys in my hand between Hawk and Stoneforge, so Bonehorde doesn't seem that big of a deal, especially since I have a Sword of Body in mind. So color seems like a pretty good thing to get, especially if I draw Cunning Spark Mage. See what his plan is here. This hand is a little weak against Jace. Alright, so he gets his pick of anything. I think he's probably going to take Squadron Hawk here, actually, since that is the one with the most value. I mean, taking an equipment doesn't seem that great, especially since I've got three in my hand and another Stoneforge. And he can't take Gideon. I guess if he really wanted to, he could take a Collar or a Sword of Body in mind. Alright, so he did take the Sword of Body in mind and play another Hawk. Well, ooh, a Plains, that's pretty good. So, I'm pretty sure I'm going to be using Stoneforge here. Actually, my equipment kind of sucks. I'm just going to bash for one and start playing Hawks. So, I get to play a Hawk and get to play one of my equipment as well. Plus, I don't really want to draw another Hawk here, so might as well play it first. I think I'm going to play Adventuring Gear. I don't see myself equipping Basilisk Collar to any of the idiots I have in play right now. I mean, yeah, I'll gain a life. Whee! Alright, the Hawks are coming in. I think I can take it. My guys are better than his because of equipment, so I'll take a hit. And plus, if I block there and he plays Jace, it's a lot worse for me. But he probably, if he had Jace, he probably wouldn't be bashing with the Hawks. Alright, so he's down to just two cards in hand. I wouldn't be surprised if some of them are removal of some kind. Alright, so equipping gear doesn't seem like it helps. Bonehorde doesn't really do anything. I've got one guy in the bin. Alright, time to just keep playing Hawks. I guess I don't even really want to trade a Stoneforge for a Hawk, and I'll just keep playing equipment. Gideon would be tough if he had a Gideon. If he had a Jace, like if he had either of his Planeswalkers, would be pretty tough to beat here. Obviously, a Sword isn't going to be a huge deal, especially since I can chump and then Divine Offering it, or even equip Collar or something. But it doesn't look like he's got a ton of action over there. Another Inquisition. Alright, didn't expect a third. Ship it, Hala. We'll see what he's up to. So now, whether he takes Divine Offering, I mean, if he has a sword in hand, taking Divine Offering is easy, but I don't think he's got a sword right now. I guess he's just banking on drawing one, and he probably doesn't think I've got any other good equipment. I mean, he knows about Bonehorde, but if I draw, you know, a Bonehorde's not going to be incredibly great on this board, and Divine Offering makes it so he's got plenty of good cards to draw in his deck. Alright, so we're bashing. Yeah, I guess I could trade one. Yeah, one's fine. Alright. Making the inevitable Bonehorde even bigger. Ooh, that's pretty good. I can get his Hawks, but I don't even know if I need to do that right now. Let's put Adventuring Gear on Squadron Hawk. Play a Stoneforge. And get the Bonehorde. Alright, I don't really want to trade Stoneforge for Hawk since I've got Arc Trail in hand. And, though I guess I could have put Adventuring Gear on Stoneforge since I'm actually going to block a Hawk here. So that would have, so I just actually moved the gear to the wrong guy. Since I'm going to block a Hawk, then Arc Trail the other two Hawks, making it so if he draws a sword, he at least can't get me right away with it. So yeah, that was an error. We'll see if that ends up, how much that ends up mattering. He's got two cards in hand. Well, they're not anything too awesome, that's for sure. Alright, let's lead with Arc Trail here. See what he says about that. And yeah, if I had gear on a guy. So basically I missed 4 points of damage. Because right now I'm going to just attack with one of the Stoneforges and use the other one to put Bonehorde in. But if I had gear on a Stoneforge, I would be doing an extra 4 points of damage here. So hopefully that doesn't end up being too bad. I mean, Hawk is the normal target for gear, but in this case, it definitely should have been Stoneforge. Alright, so let's put Bonehorde in. It's a 7-7 now? Jeez, that is pretty sweet. yeah, I'm just going to play Gideon, so let's just attack and see what happens. Stoneforging out every single equipment. Alright, he's got some sort of removal, maybe? Using removal on the Germ token is so bad, but yeah, I guess he's gotta do it. Alright, so he takes two. The moving the gear on the wrong guy adds up some more damage here. Although if I had gear on a Stoneforge, he would have killed the Stoneforge and left me with the Germ token this turn. Here I'm playing Gideon and plus two. This way he can't play his own Gideon, is the main reason. And it's, you know, the best threat I can play here, so yeah, I'm pretty sure he's just dead.